I next request our chief guest, Mr. Pankaj Patel, to address the audience. Thank you.
Professor Jain, other faculty members, students, and the invited guest, thank you very much for inviting me to be with you this evening and be part of your concluding ceremony, or whatever you call it, of the 10 years of IIT Gandhinagar. I think, Professor Jain, you mentioned about introspection. And I would start from that introspection word. I think learning from mistake is one way to actually excel in education. And this introspection, what you talked about, I believe, should be kind of a continuous improvement process for the organization, whether it's company or a business or an academic institution. So this introspections and from the introspection, learning and improving is something which ultimately will take you towards the journey of excellence. With my, I remember my early days when I wanted to get into education, I started a small school. And everybody said, what's the name? I said, company name is Zydus, so school be Zydus. And I said, no, it should be called Zydus School for Excellence. And he said, why you want to put that? I said, everybody should think about excellence every time they enter here. Similarly, you have chosen to talk about innovation. And I think it's very relevant from your perspective and from education perspective. Because there are three basic pillars on which the IITs are built. Of course, the faculty and the students are a very important part. And the another important part is academics, which includes both teaching and research. And when you talk about research, innovation becomes a very important part of the whole thing. The question is, if that is what the institute wants to do it, the question comes into, what do you mean by innovation, and what do you mean by innovation, what our country needs? So I think whenever we talk about innovation, because they're very fashionable these days to talk about research, innovation. In fact, Innovate India might be another next slogan come as a part of our PM's desire to give one more slogan. What is going to be important for us is that, are we going to do relevant innovation for our country? So one can talk about blockchain. One can talk about artificial intelligence, equally important. I'm not saying that we should not learn or we should not do it. But what is relevant for India is what we need to really think about. If we are going to add 20 million graduates or adults into the stream every year and find jobs from them, if we don't do the relevant innovation, nothing really going to help our country. The issue we have are many. You can talk about one of the biggest issue is water. We see that God is not kind to us, and because we still believe and depend on God. We have created this problem for ourselves, but now we blame God for that. The question is, we have problems and plenty in our country, whether it's hygienic condition, whether it's infrastructure, whether it's requirement of water, providing housing, even food might become a scarcity the way we are growing. If all that has happened, India has to do relevant research. And I think IITs can contribute a lot in terms of creating innovation which is relevant to our nation. We might get global recognition. We might get a Nobel Prize because of doing a research. But I think what is going to be relevant, that is not going to help our people. And if we have an institute in India, the goal of all of us should be to create an institute which will actually help our people. And I think I'm happy to learn that a lot of these, from a social commitment point of view, IIT Gandhinagar is already doing it. But other thing which I have seen, and my experience tells me a little bit, of course, not long enough in academics, is that it's not important that student has learned the science properly, but the confidence which he builds himself, inside himself, is very important. and his sensitivity to the socio-economic need of our nation is very important. So one experiment which has worked well in one of the institutes where I work is that we send our student to select a project for a tribal area. And on that project, we want to go them to go and spend a week as a part of their annual curriculum. And we've seen significant change in the confidence of the students. The way they come across, the way they think about is much different. So I think it's very important. This is not the idea you should follow blindly, but I'm saying that, and you are already doing some of these, like the workers who are here, particularly construction worker children and all that. You do a lot of things for that. What I'm trying to say is that the more we do this, we will build the next generation which is more sensitive to the requirement of our nation. Because unless we do it, we all will go to US or Europe to find greener posture there and not really contribute to our nation. And which is going to be very important if we have to generate jobs, if we have to see the vision of New India as our Prime Minister is talking about. The other thing which I have seen, and you might be doing it, but I just always have seen that when we talk about introspections, it is not enough to basically sit in a room and talk about it, but maybe create a kind of a ecosystem for feedback. And I think academic audit becomes a very relevant thing there. Okay, to some extent, most of the people talk about, we say we do academic audit, but I think we need to really graduate to move towards creating a kind of academic environment where students, faculty, and even the stakeholders who actually take your students all contribute towards giving us feedback on what we are doing and basically learn from there and take it forward how we can even be better. So once again, congratulations for your 10-year successful journey. This 10-year has been remarkable for the institute because it's built from the scratch. You also have been fortunate to build from scratch and create your own ecosystems and processes and systems at here. But I think you must remember that all that has been happened because of one reason, and that is Gujarat. If you come to this land, you will realize that the land itself, when you put your foot down, it gives you a different vibration. And that allows you to think differently and create a new things. And I think, I being Gujarati, I'm proud to say that, and I would always say that, but I'm saying that I've heard this from many people, and I think this is very important because the whole environment here, the whole thing here, everybody is progressive, everybody wants to think future and progress, and I think that is what I think IIT Gandhinagar also is going to achieve. I want to wish IIT Gandhinagar even more success in next decade and maybe an opportunity to again be here after 10 years to be with you and talk about how and where we have progressed. Thank you very much.